Hello, welcome to a special edition of Touchline. We're in the boardroom here at Red Hall, the home of the RFL, where the decision has just been made that means Widnes will be playing in Super League from next year.
And after careful consideration, the RFL board has decided that the Super League licence from 2012 will be awarded to Widnes Vikings.
And as you can imagine, the news went down very well in Widnes.
The Super League licence from 2012 will be awarded to Widnes Vikings.
Oh, wow. A bit of an understatement, must be pleased, yeah. I think I'm really pleased for the club, for Steve O'Connor, for everybody who's put a lot of work in over the last few years, and especially for the fans. This is something that means a lot to them.
A phenomenal amount of work's gone into ensuring that our bid was irresistible to Rugby League, but obviously we're delighted that Rugby League can see what value we could add to the competition next year.
So Widnes overjoyed, disappointment no doubt for Barrow. At least for Halifax, they have another chance of making it into Super League when the announcement is made in July.
Next time there's a licence up for grabs from the Championship, that they're in an unbeatable position. But of course that's not to write off their chances in July, because they're going to be up against and competing with the existing Super League clubs, not all of whom are having an easy time at the moment. So we'll just have to see how it works out in July, but I certainly think Widnes are a case study for other clubs to look at.
So the focus remains very much on the Super League licensing process, with the existing Super League clubs putting in their applications for an announcement in July.
As I was walking into the office yesterday, I didn't bump into, but I walked past John Keir and the Wakefield delegation handing in their licence application, and of course they're all coming in, some have come in, some still to come in. For the deadline, it creates a lot of excitement, and it's a very good and very healthy process for the clubs.
Well, I'm very confident. I mean, I've sort of been party to, and I've witnessed the amount of hard work that's gone into putting the application together, and I think with the new owner Andrew Glover we can certainly put together a very good business plan, and things are looking very bright off the field. I think things are looking also bright on the field with the effort and endeavour of the players.
When licensing was introduced 3 years ago, there were some concerns that it could make the game less competitive at both Super League and Championship level.
If it was a closed shop, and if results were to be completely disregarded, then that would be a concern, but that's not the case. There is still a plain imperative. You know, first of all, for an aspirant club, you have to tick the box that says to get to a Championship final or win the Northern Rail Cup. So there is a faithful adherence to the priority that is on-field performance that is there, but it's not just that, and that's the important thing. And I think that you're seeing right now far more young talent being produced by all of the clubs, and that's been achieved because clubs feel comfortable that if they have to have a season where they might not be a contender for the competition, because they're bringing young players, so they're prepared to do that. And similarly, clubs are prepared to invest in facilities, and you're seeing around the league an investment in facilities that give these clubs the best chance of actually progressing in the medium term and the long term, rather than that short termism that just goes with avoiding defeat so you don't get relegated, or winning that match so you get promoted.
So with Widnes guaranteed Super League status from 2012, the RFL now have to select the remaining 13 clubs who will make up the competition.
That's right, the Super League clubs are due to submit their applications by 1st of April, tomorrow, so there is pressure on them to deliver, but they're very clear about what they need to do. They need to put the very, very best case forward that they can.
Well, that's it from a special edition of Touchline for this week. No doubt today's decision has caused much debate, and you can have your say on facebook.com/UK Super League.